Hi there, this is Matt from Matt's English, and in this video, I'm going to be reading a story, Papa Bear, this story, Papa Bear, by an Australian author, but with a Chinese background. So this story is currently being read and analysed by EAL students here in Victoria. And I think it will be interesting for many of my students because this Australian author, his family were migrants from China. And many of my students are migrants from China or international students from China as well. So this story is by the Australian author, Qin Shen. And now I'm going to read through the story, and then in a later video, if people ask for it, I will help to explain the story as well. But in this video, I simply want them to be able to listen to the story exactly as it is. And now let's begin with that story. My dad grew up in Shanghai and was raised by his grandparents. His parents worked, and still do, for the communist government. His dad had taught himself Japanese and plagiarized entire Japanese articles, translated them into Chinese, and passed them off as his wife's work. She won some prestigious national award and dined with the political elite. They were shit parents, and they had plastic fruit in their fruit bowls. In primary school, my dad would coat his daily homework sheets in a thin layer of wax, so he could scrape off the teacher's big tick and hand in the same sheet again another day. He started smoking at about 14 and sold cartons to his mates at school. He became asthmatic a few years ago, but decided he didn't like the puffer, so he quit cold turkey. He fought in street gangs until someone drove a 6-inch blade into his left buttock. So he became a pacifist and a negotiator between gangs and bought off thugs with smokes and booze. In the last year of high school, he had a relationship with one of his teachers and went to live with her in the countryside. I don't know if this is actually true or the greatest rumor my mother has ever spread. He made it to university on average marks. Mum was a genius and borderline Martian, but she missed the last page of her exams and ended up at the same university as my dad. Some crafty college slut was keen on dad and gave him 2 movie tickets, naturally assuming that he'd take her. He took my mum instead. Burned. Considering my dad looked like an anorexic Chinese mafia messenger, it's a wonder he pulled it all. Mum says she saw a kind heart. She wears glasses. 4 years later, they got married. 2 years later, they held hands. I arrived in September of 86. Dad says that when I was born, they had just $200. He decided the best thing to do would be to leave their engineering jobs and start afresh in Australia, because obviously they had a better chance of success if they couldn't speak the language and had no recognised qualifications. His right forearm was crushed in a machinery accident after a year down under, with microsurgery and skin grafts from his foot and buttocks, they stitched it back together. He got a metal rod in there, but it still looks gimpy, kind of like the strong hand from Scary Movie, except it's not strong. It's weak as balls. So he writes with his left hand now, but only in capitals. And he eats with a fork. After calling himself John for a year, my dad realized he needed a name that symbolized something more than the average white Australian male. Something strong and heroic. Something that embodied the promise and hope of his newly adopted home. But instead of looking through the phone book or a book of names for potential monikers, he took a trip to the local shopping complex. That's where he laid eyes on the brightest, reddest sign he'd ever seen. Tandy Electronics. My father named himself after an electronics store. Seriously, what hope did I have? This is the man who used to mix a little whiskey with my milk to pacify me. The same man who recorded me snoring when I was six and played the audio every day like it was a top 40 song. The same man who Googled Eva Green as soon as he got back from the cinema. The same man who doesn't believe in power naps and can drive home asleep. The same man who can play Mahjong asleep and win. The same man who chirps, "Honey, I'm home," as soon as he steps in the front door. The same man who can't wait to become senile so he can watch Tom and Jerry cartoons every day. He's the same, yet he continues to surprise me. He's my dad, and I want to grow up to be just like him. Now that's the end of the story, and I will make another video to analyze some different ideas and words in the story very soon. So thank you for now, and that is the story of Papa Bear. I'm Matt from Matt's English. Thank you very much, and I will talk to you soon.